In this session, I will be discussing the try two of next date problem. So in the rule number 10, I have taken M3 in the sense, again, so please observe. So I will treat this M1 as my condition. So if I say M1 and the next one is increment the month, can I increment the month? Hello everyone, I welcome all of you to the yet another interesting session. So in this session, I will be discussing the try two of next date problem, which I'm going to explain with respect to the decision table. Yes, guys, in my last session, I have discussed what exactly try one is all about and what exactly the mutual condition that we had faced. So all those things I have explained with respect to the different conditions which I had. So my dear students, in this session, I will be explaining the try two. So what exactly that I need to observe. So in the try two, so let me explain that. It's again very simple. So let me take a pleasure to explain the try two of next date problem. So guys, yes, that's what I have in the agenda. Let me not spend too much of time in the agenda. So let me get into the problem directly. All right. So what are the equivalence class of try two? So please observe, I am explaining the try two. So we had the try one and we had some of the issues where we cannot calculate the next date. So we had got two impossible. So in this try two, so we have improvised in some of the things. I will be showing you that. So where exactly, what exactly we have done. So let me explain that. So we have mainly worked on how to handle the leap year better in the try two. That's what you need to understand. So here, so let's understand the conditions that I have. So let me explain that from the beginning again. So guys, what is that I have here? I have M1. So M1 is what? So I will treat this M1 as my condition. So if I say M1 again, so you all know that. So I will be storing this condition. What is that I have in this condition? 30 days. M1 in the sense, the month has got 30 days. All those months, I will be treating it as a M1. So that's what you need to understand. Fine. So what is the second condition that I have? The second condition that I have is M2. So what exactly that I have in the M2? So please observe. So the months which has got 31 days, all the months I will be storing in the M2. I will consider M2 in the sense, all the months which has got the 31 days, I will be treating that as a M2. That's the condition that you need to remember. So fine. What is M3 here? So when it comes to M3, I will be treating M3 as a February. Okay. So this is what you need to understand. So fine. So we understood that. So what I have in the D1. So D1 in the sense, guys, I will have the date range from 1 to 28 days. That's what you need to understand. So fine. So I have D1. D1 is a condition. So I will have the range of dates from 1 to 28. So fine. So what are the next condition that I have? So I have stored D2. D2 is a condition. So 29. Okay. If I get the day as 29, so I will be treating it as a D2. So in the same way, I have D3. So D3 in the sense, what is that? You will understand day 30. So that's what you need to understand. So fine. So D4 also I have. So if I have D4, so I will be considering that as a day 31. So please understand 29, 30, 31. I will be storing it in the D2, D3, D4. So fine. So I have these conditions for days. I have this condition for days. I have this condition for months. All right. I have this condition for months and I have these conditions for year. So what is the difference from try one to try two that you need to observe first? So guys, I did not had this. Okay. Year is equal to 2000. So guys, this is what you need to understand. So we have worked out with the handling how to handle this leap year better. Century years we have added here. So this condition we did not had. So in my previous try one, that's what you need to observe. So this is one of the change that you can observe here. Rest everything is almost same. All right. So guys, so let's understand how exactly this adding the century year is helping us. Okay. Again, so we have 16 rules. So I have divided this into two parts. So I have 8 rules in the first part. And again, I have the remaining 8 rules in the second part. So that's what you need to observe here. I'll repeat. So I have total 16 rules. Sir, how do I identify the rules? So here, whatever I have written, 1, 2, 3. So that's what I will call it as a rule. All right. So that's what I'll call it as a rule. Let me erase that. This is what you need to understand it as a rules. How many rules I have in the second try? So you need to understand. So we have 16 rules. So fine. Let's understand the structure of the table before we get into the concept. So guys, how many condition stubs we have? We have 3 condition stubs. That's what you need to observe. But in the previous one, we did not had 3 condition stubs. So please remember that. So what is that I have in the condition stub? So in the condition stubs, I have month, days, year. So that's what I have. But when it comes to the action stub, there is a change in the action stub. So please listen to me carefully. So when it comes to the A1, I have impossible. Is it possible for me to calculate the next date? So you can say impossible. So that is the first outcome that you can expect. And the next one is increment the day. So then can I increment the day? Say for example, I have 28 as a date that I have given. So can you increment to 29? Is it possible according to the rule? Will it satisfy the rule? If that is the case, if you are able to increment, so you will get yes, increment the date. So the next one is reset the date. Can I reset the date? Yes, you can reset the date. Okay. And the next one is increment the month. Can I increment the month? Yes, you can increment the month. In the same way, can I reset the month? Yes, you can. And again, the last action, that is increment the year. So this is the things that you have in the action stub. So whenever I say A, so you need to understand it as a action stub. As I told you in the previous session, C in the sense condition stub. I have 3 conditions and I have 6 action stubs. Okay. So this is what I will call it as a action entries. And this is what I will call it as a condition entries. Wherever you find this dash, so this is what you need to understand it as a don't care condition. So in this first 8 rules, I have not included the year is what you need to observe. So I'm not considering the year in this first 8 rules. So I've considered the year in the next 8 rules. So that's what you need to observe here. So fine. So you understood the basic structure of the decision table. So now let's get into the concept. So I think you all know it's very simple. If I explain this, rest everything, you can check it. So let's help us to understand what exactly the decision table is all about. My dear students, what is that I have? So in the first condition, I have M1. And when it comes to the day, I have D1. So M1 and D1. So M1, this is the M1. So I have 30 days and I have D1. So I have 28 days. Alright, 1 to 28 days. Is it possible for me to calculate the next date? Yes, it is possible. What exactly, sir, you didn't speak in the last session. M1, D1, and you're saying I can calculate the next date. But what exactly is that, sir? Could you please speak on that? Yes, listen to me carefully. I'm considering a month. Okay, I'm considering a month which has got the 30 days. Which has got the 30 days. Let's imagine someone. Okay, let's imagine some month. Okay, so fine. I will write that month. So in this month, how many days I can have? 30 days. Fine. So I'm considering the day. The day should come within 1 to 28. 1 to 28. So my day should come within 1 to 28. So can I have the month which has got 30 days to have the date which is between 1 to 28? Of course I can have. Say for example, can I have 14? Can I have 14 in the month? In this month? Yes, of course I can have, because I can have 30 days. So here, can I have 14? So because yes, I can have, because I can have any date between 1 to 28. So that is what you need to understand. Suppose if I have given 13, can I calculate 14 in the next date? Yes, you can. That is what you need to understand. So fine. So what will be my output? Yes, of course you can calculate the next date. So increment the day. So that's what they have given. So fine. I can calculate the next date. That's what they have given it as an increment, the day. Fine. What are the next condition? Rule 2. Let's check. Again, they have given M1, D2. All right. So fine. Can I increment the date? Yes, you can increment the day. Fine. Let's go to the rule number 3. Again, they have given M1, D2. So what is that? Is it D2 or D3? So please observe carefully. Please observe carefully. So before we go to the D2, so this is what generally you will make a mistake. So whenever you are observing the conditions, you have to be very, very careful. So this is not D1, this is D2. So please pay attention here. So guys, D2. So I have taken M1 and this is D2. This is not D1. I told D1. All right. So this is D2. So what is D2? So D2 in the sense 29. If I have this case, can I calculate the next date? Yes, you can. So increment the day. So no issues with that. So hi, done. All right. So the next condition that I have again, M1 in the sense, obviously you all know that it's 30 days. So what is this D3? D3 in the sense what? Please observe D3 in the sense 30 days. So is it possible I have the month which has got the 30 days and again days 30 days. Is it possible? So that's what I'm checking. So please understand. Please understand. Yes, you can reset the day. You can reset the day. Okay, that as one. You can reset the day that has one. Why are you resetting the day, sir? Month has got 30 days and date has got 30 days. If I want to calculate the next date, how do I calculate? I need to reset the date, right? So the resetting the date to one and I need to increment the month. That's what you need to understand. Hope you got the point here. All right. So moving on to the next rule. What is the next rule that we have? M1. So that is 30 days. Fine. D4. What is the meaning of D4? So D4 in the sense 31 days. Is it possible for me? Obviously, it is not possible. So please understand. We had two impossible statements there. Do you remember in the try one? So we have one now. Could you please recollect it? Yes. Why it is not possible? I have taken the month of 30 days and you are asking me to have 31 day in the date. So how it is possible? It is impossible. So that is why I have taken it as impossible. So moving on to the next rule. What is the next rule that I have? M2 I have taken. So I am done with M1 now, as of now. So I have taken M2. M2 in the sense 31 days. Fine. For M2, again, I'm starting with D1. So D1 in the sense 28. So in the month, I have 31 days, but days should come between 1 to 28. So can I? Yes, you can. All right. So that's what we have. So in the same way, I can also calculate it for M2, D2, M2, D3. So there is no change will be there. All right. So because D2 is of 29 and D3 is of 30. So you'll not find any changes. Let me not bore you by saying again and again the same thing. So please observe here. What is that I have? M2, D4. M2 in the sense 31 days. M2 in the sense what? 31 days. D2 in the sense 29 days. D2 in the sense what? 29 days. So guys, that's what you need to observe here. So what is that I have here? So I can reset the date. I can reset the date. All right. That's what you need to understand. Moving on to the next 8 rules. So please observe that I have 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So here when you come back, so you will have rule number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's what you need to observe here. So guys, so what is that I have here? So the same thing that I will be comparing the rules. So please observe when it comes to the rule number 9. So what is that I have taken in the month? So M3 I have taken. M3 in the sense what? So I have taken the month in February. That's what I have taken. So fine. So day, that is D1. D1 in the sense 1 to 28. That's what I have taken. So what is that? So reset the date and increment the month. That's what you need to do it. So when you take it as year, that is Y1. So what is that Y1? So Y1, that year is 2000. That's what you have to do is what the rule says. So fine. So guys, what is the next rule that I have? So when it comes to the next rule, I have rule number 10. So in the rule number 10, I have taken M3. M3 in the sense, again, so please observe February. I will be dealing with the February. That's what you need to observe. So please observe here one thing. So first I dealt with M1, then I dealt with M2, then I'm dealing with the M3. So fine. So M3 in the sense February, D1 in the sense 28 days, and the year is Y2. So year is not a century leap year. Year is not a century leap year. That's what you need to understand. So fine. So when that is the case, so you increment the day. You increment the day is what the rule says. So fine. So moving forward to the next one. So we have M3, D1 and Y3. So when it is Y3, so please observe, year is a century leap year. Year is a century leap year. So fine. Reset the day. So reset the day. So whatever the day that you have, so you move it to the next day and increment the month is what they say. Reset the day in the sense that is the end of that month. So move to the next month. So that is what they say with the increment month. Reset the day in the sense that is in the end of the month. You start from one. That is the meaning of reset the day. So fine. So after that, 11th rule. So we are moving to the rule number 12. So guys, what is that we have with rule number 12? M3, D2 and Y1. So M3, D2, Y1. So that's what I have. M3 in the sense what? February. D2 in the sense 29 days. And so Y1 in the sense century. That is 2000. Year is 2000. So what is that I will be doing? So it is just impossible. It is impossible. I cannot have that. Okay. So 29 days will not be there. Is what you need to understand. Right. That's what you need to understand. So I don't have 29 days there. So that's not, it's not possible for me to calculate. The next date is what you need to mark. That's what you need to understand. So fine. In the same way, I am moving to the next rule. So I have M3, D2, Y2. M3 in the sense February, D2 in the sense 29 days, and Y2 century. It's not a non-century leap year. So that's what you need to understand. So for that, you can reset and increment the day. That's what you have. And the rest, everything what I have, rule number 14, 15 and 16. So what is that you need to observe? So please understand this. What is that I have here? You need to spend a little time here. I have M3. M3 in the sense, I have February. So I have D2. D2 in the sense 29 days. D2 in the sense what? 29 days. And then year is a century leap year. Year is a century leap year. That is what they say. So please understand, for that it is impossible. It is impossible. That's what you need to understand. So guys, and again, the same rule, M3, D3 and M3, D3. So again, so M3, so that is February, D3, that is 30 days. How it is possible? So guys, so please make a note of these things. M3, D3. D3 in the sense, in which February you will get 30 days. That's what you need to understand. So it is not possible for us to calculate. That's what you need to understand. So guys, this is how. So you need to understand the decision table. This is how you need to understand the decision table. So what is that you need to keep it in your mind? You have four parts in the decision table. So one is condition step, another one is action step. This is the condition entry and this is the action entry. So this is what you need to understand. So guys, I think I have traced all the rules in detail one by one. So with this, I've come to an end of the try 2. So in the next session, I will be discussing the try 3. So till then, take care. Bye-bye.